JBN, we keep you informed. I am Michelle Jones, and in the news, men wanted by the West Kingston Police. The Jamaica Constabulary Force, JCF, is once again seeking the public's help to locate these wanted persons. 22-year-old Tyreek Gale, otherwise called Pops, is wanted by the West Kingston Police for shooting with intent. Omar Burford is wanted by the West Kingston Police for murder. 27-year-old O'Shane Cooper, otherwise called BJ, is of a fair complexion, slim build, and has space front teeth, is wanted by the West Kingston Police for murder. And Roshane Samuels, otherwise called Sun Sun, is also wanted by the West Kingston Police for shooting with intent. If you know the whereabouts of any of these individuals, please call the West Kingston Police at 876-922-6641, Crime Stop at 311, the police 119 emergency number, or the nearest police station. Farmer found dead in Portland. Detectives in Port Antonio, Portland, are yet to establish a motive for the killing of farmer 50-year-old Garfield Gardner, whose body was found in bushes on Sunday afternoon. It is reported that a resident stumbled upon a trail of blood and subsequently discovered Gardner's body, which had multiple chop wounds. An alarm was raised and the police summoned. The scene was processed by investigators and the body removed to the morgue. Gardner was last seen alive about 5 p.m. Saturday, when he reportedly left his home in the community of Compound in Hectors River to go to a nearby river. 7 people have so far been murdered in Portland since the start of 2021, which is still the lowest island-wide. The police are again appealing to residents to try and settle their disputes peacefully. Firearm holder under probe following accidental shooting. Police investigators are probing the circumstances surrounding the reported accidental shooting and injuring of a mechanic in Santa Cruz, St. Elizabeth yesterday. Reports are that the licensed firearm holder, who is a 49-year-old taxi operator, was showing the weapon to the mechanic, said to be a personal friend, when it went off, hitting the other man in the upper arm. The injured man was reportedly hospitalized. "It cannot continue like this," says PNP counselor. People's National Party counselor for the Yorktown Division, Ufel Purcell, is appealing to criminals to desist from perpetrating acts of violence in the division. The appeal came hours after a resident was murdered in the Four Parts community on Sunday night. "I don't know when this will stop, but I'm imploring those guys who have the guns to stop it and give it them to the police. If there's an issue with you and someone, speak to the police or ask a justice of the peace or a pastor to help you, rather than hurting people or killing each other. It cannot continue like this. I'm imploring the citizens, especially the younger ones. It is not good for your families, and the community is feeling the pain and the pressure, and we need a solution," said Purcell in an impassioned plea. Reports are that approximately 9:29 p.m. on Sunday, residents heard explosions and summoned the police. Upon their arrival, the cops searched the area, and the body of 51-year-old Radcliffe Ian Buckley was found with what appeared to be gunshot wounds. The scene was processed and the body removed to the morgue, pending an autopsy. The police say they have no leads or suspects in this case at this time as they continue their investigations. Reflecting on the gruesome incident of the night before, Purcell said he's saddened by the murder of a resident who has been there for the longest while providing a service to the community. "I'm so shocked to hear of the murder. I don't know of Ian to be someone that is a troublemaker. I don't know of him keeping a lot of company, much less bad company. I don't know where this is coming from, but it's really heartrending. And the residents of Yorktown have lost a young man who had credible ability and someone who was very much community-oriented," said Purcell. He said he has been working with residents, Jamaica Social Investment Fund, the Member of Parliament Luther Cousins, the police, and several pastors to restore normality to the division. "I thought we're finally getting back some semblance of peace in the community. But as time goes by, we see the flip and things happen again," said Purcell. The counselor noted that Yorktown was once a peaceful community and said he is hoping that one day they can find a way to stem the growing crime problem in the area. Commission residents dispute gang count in Norwood. Residents of the newly declared Zone of Special Operations, ZOSO, in Norwood have disputed the assertion of Police Commissioner Major General Anthony Anderson that 6 gangs operate in the violence-plagued northwestern Jamaica community. "This is where I've lived all my life, and I know about 2 gangs. Ogre Lane Gang, and Church Lane Gang. So I was surprised when I heard the commissioner talking about six gangs, said one of several residents who contradicted the disclosure on Sunday. It is important that the police know how many gangs are here, so they know who to target. You can't start off with misinformation. That harks back to claims of faulty data grounding the declaration of Azoso in Mount Salem in September 2017. During Anderson's tour of Norwood on Monday, he brushed aside requests to name the gangs. I am not going to be naming them so that they can get some sort of infamy or fame from me, said Anderson. We know who the gangs are and their names, but I'm not going to particularly advertise any of them here. They are the problem in the community, and they need to be in jail or change their ways. With the Zozo into its third day, the commissioner heaped praise on the security forces, who seized two guns and 18 rounds of ammunition on Monday. He compared the achievements with those in Mount Salem, which took 14 days to turn up the first illegal gun. Mount Salem is one of two Zozos operational in St. James and five in the island. The commissioner said that seven persons in Norwood have been arrested since Sunday in relation to crimes including firearm and sexual offenses, as well as lottery scamming. Social intervention is a key deliverable of Zozos, with Mount Salem emerging as the standard bearer with the replacement of zinc fences with concrete walls, as well as the issuance of birth certificates, taxpayer registration numbers, and passports to underserved residents. A community center has been refurbished and a new police station constructed. The commissioner said he could not pronounce on the scope of social benefits that will be rolled out in Norwood. It's too early to say, said Anderson. We will follow the clear, hold, build strategy around the zones of special operations. So in the early stages, we do a number of operations against the gangs, gang members, and other criminals. Government and Carb Cement signed MOU to use end-of-life tires as fuel source. The government has signed a memorandum of understanding with Caribbean Cement Company Limited for the entity to use end-of-life pneumatic tires in the cement production process. Under the arrangement, Caribbean Cement will convert used tires at the landfills into an alternative source of fuel, thereby reducing costs and making a positive impact on the environment. Prime Minister Andrew Holness, who addressed the virtual signing ceremony held on Tuesday at Jamaica House, said that the agreement will provide a solution to the indiscriminate disposal of used tires and the stockpiling of the material at the landfills. He said it is estimated that more than 2 million used tires are generated in Jamaica per annum, and landfills receive approximately 185,700 tires per year. Most of these tires are indiscriminately disposed of along roadways, in gullies, stockpiled in open lots, and of course, stored in our landfills. And we estimate that we have approximately 2 million tires stockpiled at Riverton City, Holness said. Their very presence creates a myriad of environmental hazards, public health risks, along with other challenges. Further to that, they occupy a valuable space when ordered at landfills, he added. Holness further pointed out that tires are not biodegradable, so leaving them in a stockpile is not a solution. He commended Caribbean Cement on the innovation in transforming the used tires into a fuel source. He said that the production of cement is a highly intensive, energy-consuming activity, with statistics on the Cement Sustainable Initiative 2002 indicating that it takes approximately 60 to 130 kilograms of fuel oil and 110 kilowatt hours of electricity to produce 1 ton of cement. As such, it is important that the cement industry identifies ways in which it can substitute fossil fuel for sustainable alternative energy sources. End-of-life tires are ideal for use as an alternative fuel in cement production, he noted. Holness said that the signing symbolizes a change in perception from waste as a problem to waste as a resource. The problems that we need to overcome and the opportunities that we must grasp are interwoven. They are not separate things. The lesson that we should learn is that whatever presents a problem, if you search hard enough, if you approach it from an innovative perspective, you can actually find an opportunity. Caribbean Cement's Managing Director, Iago Castro, for his part, said that the signing ceremony symbolizes the continuation of a long-standing partnership between the company and the government. It represents an extension of our purpose of being responsible corporate citizens and will result in positive environmental and social impacts, he noted. At Carib Cement, achieving environmental excellence is a priority. We dedicate efforts to addressing key sustainability-related issues from biodiversity and conservation to renewable energy, climate change, and emissions monitoring, Castro said. Other signatories were Minister of Housing, Urban Renewal and Climate Change, Colonel Charles Jr., and Minister of Local Government and Rural Development, Desmond Mackenzie. Jamaica recorded 60 new COVID-19 cases, 5 deaths. Jamaica recorded 60 additional COVID-19 cases yesterday and 5 deaths, bringing the infection total to 49,795 and the total deaths to 1,042. According to reports from the Ministry of Health and Wellness, the new cases comprise of 31 females and 29 males within the ages of 10 months old and 90 years old. These cases were recorded in St. Anne, 17, St. Catherine and Kingston and St. Andrew, 9 each, St. James, 8, Westmoreland, 5, St. Mary, 4, Clarendon, 3, Hanover, St. Elizabeth, 2 each, St. Thomas, 1. Deaths include a 42-year-old male from St. James, a 60-year-old male from St. James, a 50-year-old female from St. James, whose death was previously under investigation, a 63-year-old female from Manchester, and a 69-year-old male from St. Mary. The country had 195 recoveries, bringing the total to 29,130, resulting in 19,256 active cases. 120 people are still hospitalized, 8 of which are critically ill, while 29 are moderately ill. JBN, we keep you informed. Please remember to subscribe, like, share, leave us a comment, and click the notification bell to receive our daily news items.